Hello, my name is Jeff Kavanagh with KE2 Therm Solutions. In this video, I'll cover the steps for configuring the KE2 Low Temp or KE2 Adaptive Controller for use with a door switch using the controller's front panel. By this point, you should have already installed the door switch and wired it to the controller. If you need assistance with this, please see video 42, How to Wire a KE2 Low Temp or KE2 Adaptive Control for use with a door switch. First, let's take a look at the illustration of the controller's navigation. As you see, under the advanced menus, the set point AU2 is circled. This stands for Auxiliary Input 2. Either AU1 or AU2 can be used for the door switch. However, the KE2 Adaptive is factory programmed with AU1 as second coil sensor. The options for auxiliary inputs shown here down the list is door. Okay, so now let's go down to the front of the controller. Press and hold the back button for 3 seconds to access advanced menus. Use the up or down arrow to navigate through the set points until you see AU2. Short press enter to access the options for AU2. Then use the down arrow to scroll through the options until you see door. Now press and hold enter for 3 seconds. Next, we need to configure the controller to function with a normally open or normally closed door switch. To do this, we press the down arrow until we see STA2, which stands for Digital Input Active State. Short press the enter. The default is short. Leave it as short for normally open door switch, or use the down arrow to change it to open for a normally closed door switch. To save your changes, press and hold enter for 3 seconds. Another feature of the KE2 Low Temp is that it can also send out email or text alarms when connected to the internet using a KE2 Local dashboard and alarms communication module. More details on this benefit are found on our videos on the KE2 LDA product. For more information, please visit our website or contact our tech support line.